If I sound stuffy, the situation that we're in caught up with me and I'm currently dealing with it, don't worry. I've been vaccinated. I'm fine. I've got the pattern there and some tissues. I've got thread, buttons, zipper, all of that here. That's for the pocket lining. That's the actual trousers. I think I filmed an intro for this. It'll be in front of it, so you know the context behind this whole project. Everything is now pinned down. I've drawn out the waistband, which is just a simple rectangle, so I decided not to make a pattern. Since this is based on a short trousers pattern, I had to lengthen the legs by quite a bit. So I've just drawn that on with chalk. You can still see there. And now I'm gonna go ahead and cut it out. Alright, I have everything cut out. I've got a few pieces here that I've already taken the paper off. I've got the front, waistband, and the back. And now I'm gonna take the pattern off and I'm going to transfer all of the markings that I've made on this side to the other side with the help of pins and a white pencil. And chalk, probably. And after that, I'm probably gonna overlock a few edges and baste a few edges and some lines. Am I not? I'm gonna see. Thank you.
come nearly as far as I thought I would, or I hoped I would. I have some trouble with sewing in front fly zippers. And I did not film every little bit of it because I'm still kind of learning it myself, and I follow like a step-by-step guide that I made with the help of a video of Kulerpa. I'll link that one down below. It's really, really helpful one. She's basically the one who taught me how to do this. Other things I did was stitching kind of the pocket bags, and I've cut everything out and overlocked all of the necessary edges. Done the pleats in the front. I'm not very sure if this is the final position. I've basted them now, and I'm gonna keep it that way until very final. I've pressed a whole bunch of things, and I think tomorrow I'm gonna baste a few pieces of fabric in this place where the, what is it, pocket welt strip will be. And I'm gonna do a fitting. I need to put the trousers together for that quite loosely, so I do not want to put the pockets in yet, because it's mostly about the back darts. I have darts in here, but they're quite small, and I do recall from the previous use of this pattern that I do need to take a little bit more fabric out here, and maybe even in the center back seam. So I'm gonna do a rough construction tomorrow, just with big stitches. And once I have that done, I'm gonna take it all apart and put in the pockets and continue proper construction. Coming to you at the end to say that this is the end of this video. It's getting quite long. Apparently I very thoroughly filmed the process of making these trousers. Also, I did not find any intro. I wanted to show you my sketch of the trousers. This is what they're supposed to look like. And also, if I keep talking about previous trousers, these are those. I made these, I think, summer last year, 2021. And they were made from a burda pattern that I have in one of the magazines. And they're the super cute jungle printed linen trousers, and I've worn these so damn much that I'm actually kind of sad that I cannot wear it right now. I already had to replace the button once because I wore them so often. So it stands to reason that I need a winter pair as well. I should have the trousers finished this week. I hope to have all of the footage edited and into videos before December starts, because for December I have something grand planned. I don't know how many videos will be in this project. I actually had not planned at all to have multiple videos about this project. I was planning only one, but this is what happened. Thank you for watching anyway. If you liked it, please let me know. If you want to see more of the process of making these trousers, you can subscribe, which is, I believe, also here somewhere. It'll be somewhere there as well. If you like to see more of my work, go to my Instagram, and there will probably be some pictures up of these trousers before the next video. Again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video about this project.